Can't believe you're here now. Tell me dream come true. The answer to the prayer now. I'm so in love with you. Couldn't wait to meet you. Hope you like your name. I get the funny feeling life will never be the same. Safe and sound, you're here with me now. Like I hoped you'd be. Safe and sound, you're here with me now. That's all. It's a scary place here, but baby, it's alright. I'll make sure the coast is clear, so you can just get tired. If you're afraid of monsters, like everybody is, I'll be right beside you, closer than a kiss. Safe and sound, I'll be here with you now. And you will always be.
Child in the life of our congregation. Whenever we welcome a child in the life of our congregation, we are really welcoming them into the life of Christ, because Jesus is the life of our church. And this morning, it is my privilege to present to you Ryan and Jen Detweiler, and their handsome son, Life of Christ, hair tone and everything. And actually, this morning, we're doing three dedications. Ryan and Jen have come to dedicate Nolan to the Lord. This is in keeping with a rich biblical tradition in which they are bringing Nolan and presenting him to God as an offering, recognizing that God is Nolan's Heavenly Father, and that He made Nolan, and that he rightfully belongs to Him, and that God has a special plan for Nolan's life that must begin and end and find its meaning everywhere in between in relationship with Jesus Christ. Similar to how Hannah of old brought her son Samuel in dedication to the Lord. She said, I bring him that he may appear before the Lord and stay there forever. She said, for this boy I pray, the Lord has given me my petition which I asked of him. So I have also dedicated him to the Lord. As long as he lives, he is dedicated to the Lord, and he worshiped the Lord there. Today as well, Ryan and Jen are dedicating themselves to the ministry of parenting. But parenting is not something that we do to fill time in a particular season of life, nor is it something we do to relive our own childhood vicariously through our kids, but it is a calling of God. And for any hope or aspiration that a father or mother might have to Christian ministry, it first must be demonstrated by having a ministry mindset in the home. We learned this from the scriptures going all the way back to the very beginning, but I think particularly of the words in Deuteronomy chapter 6, where parents were admonished in this way. Love the Lord your God with all of your heart, with all of your soul, with all of your might. These words which I am commanding you today shall be on your heart, and you shall teach them diligently to your sons, and talk about them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise up. You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontals on your forehead. And you shall write them on the doorpost of your house and on your gates. And this morning, as a congregation, we are also dedicating ourselves anew to be the kind of place and the kind of people where Nolan will be able to grow up learning the truth about who God is, and where he will be challenged to walk each day faithfully in the footsteps of Jesus Christ. And we are pledging to be the kind of environment where Ryan and where Jen can receive the encouragement, the support, the nurture, and all of the equipping they're going to need to fulfill their God-given calling. I think of the words of Jesus from Matthew chapter 18, where we read, "At the time the disciples had come to Jesus, saying, 'Who then is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?' And Jesus called a child to himself and set him before them. He said, 'Truly I say to you, unless you are converted and become like children, you shall not enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever then humbles himself as this child, he is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever receives one such child in my name receives me. But whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to stumble, it is better for him that a heavy millstone be hung around his neck and that he be drowned in the depth of the sea. Woe to the world because of its stumbling blocks, for it is inevitable the stumbling blocks come. But woe to the man through whom the stumbling block comes. And if your hand or your foot cause you to stumble, cut it off and throw it from you. It is better for you to enter life crippled or lame than have two hands or two feet to be cast into the eternal fire. And if your eye causes you to stumble, pluck it out and throw it from you. It is better for you to enter life with one eye than having two eyes and be cast into the fiery hell. See that you do not despise one of these little ones, for I say to you that their angels in heaven continually behold the face of my Father who is in heaven." And so we want to be that kind of community where children can see Jesus and learn what it means to follow him faithfully in life. So Ryan and Jen, I want to give you an opportunity this morning to affirm your intentions to dedicate Nolan and yourselves to the Lord this morning. Do you accept Nolan as a gift from God? And do you not acknowledge that he rightfully belongs to him? Do you acknowledge that it is your duty to see to it that Nolan is taught the meaning of the Christian life? And do you promise with God as your helper to guide him by your teaching and your example in such a way that later in his life, he may make his own choice to believe upon the Lord Jesus Christ and dedicate himself to Christ's service? Amen. We'd like to share a person this morning. We give you an opportunity to do that.
Nolan, you are truly a blessing from God, and we believe that God created you especially for us. As you grow, our prayer for you is that you will come to know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and that you would find your identity in him. While words cannot describe the love we feel for you, we acknowledge that you are just a gift to us from God. We pray that you will mirror his example of serving others, of loving unconditionally, and of extending grace and forgiveness to all that you come in contact with. As your parents, we commit to teaching you about Christ by bringing you to church, through the reading of his word, through discipline, and by praying for you. We recognize that we will not be able to do this alone and ask for the prayers and support of our church and immediate family. It has been such a joy watching you grow. The happiness we felt when we first saw you, when you first smiled, and when you first laughed cannot be described. We look forward to all the firsts that are yet to come. Only God knows the awesome plans that he has in store for you in the future. And we hope that you remember the following verses from Jeremiah 29:11-13. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future. Then you will call upon me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart."
Grace Mennonite Church, will you affirm your commitment to Nolan and to Ryan and Jen this morning by standing and turning in your worship? Actually, here's number 791. 791. Let us read this as our commitment to them this morning. It's not 791. This has happened to me before. I have 791. What number is it?
729.
729. says I'm dying to do something. Let's read this together. You have offered your child strong and tender products to God
and to the nurture of the church.
We accept with humility of spirit and seriousness of purpose our responsibility for the spiritual well-being of this child.
By our example and our words, we will support your parental role in disposing this child to respond to the fullness that is in Christ. We earnestly pray that the life and the witness of each of us will make your task both joyful and fruitful.
Heavenly Father, this morning we come before you with a joy in our hearts and a song upon our lips for this gift that truly comes from you. And as we've already said this morning, Lord, we affirm that Nolan belongs to you. Lord, you made him in your image. You fashioned him according to your likeness. And Father, you set a love upon him. Father, we ask that the Spirit of the Lord Jesus Christ will continue to give him everything he needs to be the man of God you made him to be. Father, give him a mind of reason, a heart of compassion, a spirit of discernment, that he might know the difference between right and wrong, and from an early age to be able to separate truth from error. May you give him the gift of faith, that he will find it easy to put his trust in you, and that he will see you modeled faithfully in life, and that he will surrender himself to your service and to your service alone. And of his own choice, Lord, may he depend only upon the mercy and grace of the Lord Jesus Christ for his own salvation and for his daily walk. Lord, we pray that he will faithfully look to you in all things, that his eyes be fixed upon you. Lord, we ask that he would walk faithfully in your footsteps all the days of life, and he would dwell in your house forever. And may you bless Ryan and Jen with all that they need to fulfill their God-given calling. Strengthen them in their life, strengthen them in their marriage. Nurture their home with encouragement, joy, and peace. And Lord, may the joy of Jesus just overflow their walls each and every day. May the truth of your infallible word be affirmed within the walls of their home. And Lord, may they diligently labor in this ministry of parenting, finding the help from you that also comes from the support of their godly family and their church. Lord, we commit ourselves to you and to them this day for your glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Nolan, it is my honor to dedicate you to the church and to the Christian life in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Will you turn in your Mennonite hymnals as we sing a song in response?
In 337, what a grand man.